children. I am Mrs. Geetham Singh. Today I am going to teach you a chapter of class 12, that is solution. It is the second chapter of your book. So let us start with the topic solution. Okay? Solution. You must have studied in 9th class the solution. Solution is a mixture of two or more substances that is called solution. For example, if we dissolve sugar in water, you must have done this practice many times at home. So, dissolving sugar in water, the combination of both sugar and water is called solution. We can take another example also, if we dissolve salt in water, or you can dissolve any other thing in any other solvent, that is called solution. Okay. Now, moving to the next, that is, what are the characteristics of solution? Characteristics. First characteristic. Solution exists in one phase only. Means, after making the solution, it will exist in one phase only. That is, so liquid phase or solid phase or gaseous phase. For example, if you dissolve sugar in water, after dissolution of sugar in water, it is in liquid phase. You must have seen the solution appears in the liquid phase. So, we can say that solution exists in one phase only. Second characteristic. The composition of sugar can be varied. Composition means what is being dissolved in solvent. Both solute and solvent can be varied. The amount of solute and solvent can be varied. How? Can be varied to certain limit. Can be certain limit. Means, if I dissolve 1 gram of sugar in 1 liter of water, it is considered as solution. Or, if we dissolve 1 kg of sugar in water, that is also considered as a solution. So, the amount of solute and solvent can be varied in making the preparing the solution. The ratio is not fixed. Now, third characteristic, solution mainly contains two components, that is solute and solvent. You must be knowing the solute and solvent, they both combine and they called as solution. Okay, so what is solute? Solute is a substance which is being dissolved. The substance which is being dissolved is called solute. And what about the solvent? Solvent is a substance in which the solute is being dissolved. Okay, solute and solvent, they both form solution. Now, these are the few characteristics. Moving to the next heading, that is classification. How can we classify the solution? Classification of solution can be done on the different basis. One by one, I am taking it. First is on the basis of on the basis of number of components in the solution. First type is binary solution. Binary. Second is ternary solution. Ternary solution. Binary solution is a solution in which there is only one solute and one solvent. Only two components are mixed together in solution. One solute and one solvent. We can take example of sugar solution. Sugar dissolved in water. There are two components present in this solution. That is, first one is sugar, second is water. Now, this type of solution is called as binary solution. Sugar solution contains sugar plus water. Sugar plus water, two component, that is binary solution. Now moving to the next, that is ternary solution. Ternary solution contains three component. For example, salt plus sugar plus water. Here there are three components present. One is salt, next is sugar, and third one is water. So this type of solution is considered as ternary solution. Okay. Now next category, on the basis of physical appearance. So what is that? Physical appearance. That is homogeneous and heterogeneous. Heterogeneous solution. All of you have read what is homogeneous and heterogeneous. Homogeneous means in the solution in which the appearance is uniform. Same type of appearance is seen in the whole body of the solution. For example, sugar solution. In sugar solution, after dissolving sugar in water, solution has been prepared, and you will see that whole solution is uniform in appearance. Okay. So next is heterogeneous. Heterogeneous, we can take example of soil in water, or sand in water, or chalk in water. These all three examples are called as heterogeneous solution, because in this we see different appearance in different location of the solution. They are not uniform. They are called as non-uniform solution. Non-uniform solution is named as heterogeneous solution. This is on the basis of the appearance. Moving to the next classification. Third type. On the basis of phase, whether the solution is in liquid phase or in gaseous phase or in solid phase, they are categorized according to the phase condition of the solution. First one is gaseous solution. Gaseous solution, solvent is in gaseous phase, and solute can be in gas, liquid, or solid. Gases, there are three types of gaseous solution: gas plus gas. Example, air. Air is a mixture of gas. So, air exists in which phase? Gaseous phase. So, air is a mixture of gas, and it is a example of gaseous solution. Next is liquid plus gas.
liquid in gas, humidity, humidity or moisture. Solvent is air or gas, and small droplets of water are present in air. That's why they are called as solution of liquid in gas, humidity and moisture. These are the examples. Now next is solid plus gas. Best example is smoke. In smoke, unburnt carbon particle are present in air. You must have seen chimneys, lot of black smoke coming out from the chimney. That is smoke which is consisting of unburnt carbon particle dissolved in air. Okay, this is all about the gaseous solution. Now next, is liquid solution. In this, solvent is in liquid phase and solute in gaseous or liquid or solid phase. They can exist in any of the three types. Now gas in a liquid, example oxygen dissolved in water. That is why oxygen is dissolved in water. That's why aquatic plants and animal, they exist in water. They can survive in water. Our next example, aerated drinks. Cold drink. You can take example of cold drink. Cold drink is also a mixture of gas in liquid. Okay, gas, so carbon dioxide is dissolved in water. Then only we get that taste, strong flavor of the cold drink. Second, liquid in liquid. Example, alcohol in water. Alcohol in water, or you can take any other example. In this type, both a solute and solvent are present in liquid phase. Third, solid in liquid. You can also give the example of this type. Simple, very simple, easy example, salt in water or sugar in water. Salt and sugar exist in solid phase and water is present in liquid phase. So in liquid solution, again we have studied three types. Okay, now next, solid solution. Here solvent is present in solid state. Solvent always exists in solid state. Gas in solid. Example, you can take oxygen in nitrogen gas. Liquid in solid. We can take example, mercury in sodium. We call it sodium amalgam. Mercury is just in liquid phase, solid sodium is in solid state, mercury in sodium is liquid in solid solution. Now last one is solid in solid. Very good example is alloy. Alloy is a mixture of different metal we daily use in our daily life. Okay, this is all about the classification of solution. There are a few small terms which I am going to remind you. You must have studied in lower classes. Miscible solution means when solute and solvent are both are soluble in each other. That solution is called miscible. Okay, solute is miscible in solvent. Immiscible means when solute and solvent both are immiscible with each other, means they are not soluble. You can take example of oil in water. Oil never dissolve in water. Therefore, this type of solution you can call it as immiscible solution. Next is aqueous solution. Aqueous solution means when solvent is taken as solvent is water. When solute is dissolved in water, then the solution is named as aqueous solution. Aqua means in chemistry, aqua means water. When any solute is dissolved in water, then that solution is named as aqueous solution. Non-aqueous solution means here solvent is other than water. Except water, you can take any other solvent. Then, because so that solute is not soluble in water, so we can dissolve that type of solute in any other solvent. In this way, we have taken solvent other than water. Then that type of solution is known as non-aqueous solution. For example, we can say sulfur in oil. Sulfur is soluble in oil. So here, which solvent we have taken? Oil. Okay. These are the few terms. You should know the meaning of all these terms. That's all for today. Thank you.